Allie and I'm 9 years old. After my dog got stung by a bee and had an allergic reaction, I decided to make a bee collar that deters bees from dogs and doesn't make them sting for Invention Convention. I love all types of animals and taking care of them. When I grow up, I want to be a vet.
Hi, my name is Dr. Nicole Bruno, and I'm a veterinarian. Hi, Allie.
Thank you for your time for talking with me.
Thanks for having me.
First up, what type of vets are there and what type of vet are you?
So I am a small animal veterinarian. So that means I deal with cats and dogs primarily. But there are other veterinarians that only do exotic medicine. So they'll work with birds and chinchillas and rabbits and hamsters and sometimes even just reptiles. There are a lot of different pathways. There's even mixed animals where people do a little bit of everything. Do you think you want to work with exotics?
I just like avian exotics because I love chickens, I love rabbits, I love ferrets, I love a little bit of snakes, barely.
Okay. Well, there are veterinarians that you can decide what you want to treat, and that makes it even better for you.
This question is from CJ, who wants to know, how do you know what's wrong with a pet if they can't talk?
So there's a lot of ways that we know what's going on. A lot of times we ask the owners, getting that history helps us to kind of understand what could be going on. And then the examination, when we put them on the exam room table or I get on the floor, I do the same exam and you know what normal is and then you know what abnormal is. A lot of times putting all of that together, allows us to know what's going on with the pet even though they can't speak.
Elvie wants to know, was it hard studying to become a vet?
It was definitely very challenging. It's a lot of material that we have to learn in a very short period of time. And we have to learn not only about the cat and the dog, but also the horse and the cow. So I wanted to be a vet when I was 12 years old. So from the time I was 12, going through junior high and high school, then college, then vet school, like just getting to that finish line made me feel like I could do anything. Like I really believed in myself. It's a lot, but it can be done.
If my dog collar was available in the market, would you use it in your practice?
I sure would. And I've treated a lot of puppies similar to your dog, Tilly, that got a bee sting. So anything and everything that we can put on that's natural, I would give it a try.
Yay. What was your favorite day of being a vet?
I think my favorite parts of being a vet is when I can make an animal feel better. I can figure out what's wrong with them when they can't speak and give the right medications or talk to the owners about how we can make them feel better. And when they are better, that just makes my day even better.
How has being a vet made an impact on your life?
Most people think being a veterinarian is about the animals, but what I've learned that I have become more impactful in is the people that own the pets, because I have to, talk to them and I develop a relationship with them and they trust me with their pets. And so I think that that's something that has impacted me because it's made me a lot more compassionate, not only to the pets, but to the people that own them.
What advice would you give me and the other kids who want to be vets?
And the earliest that you can start to get exposure is so important. There's so many TV shows that you can watch about animals and learn, and see veterinarians on TV. If you have a pet, take care of them, help your parents feed them, brush their teeth, play, help trim their nails. It just teaches you, how to work with animals.
Me and my sister, we have a lot of animals, a lot of chickens.
Wow.
And so we'll worm them, we'll do all that stuff our own.
That's good. And it's challenging to give them medications at times, right?
A rooster that attacks and he's not easy to give medications. Well, thank you for your time and I hope that I'm able to become a vet like you.
Oh, well, no problem. Thank you for having me and I'm gonna look out for you. So keep in touch, okay?
Okay.